Music for Usain Bolt running and not looking back. It's the yam, it's the dumplings, it's the banana. One of the hottest roots rock reggae bands from the island of Jamaica. They are called Raging Fire. That track, Nah Look Back, produced by Rory from Stone Love. As I said earlier on in the show, he's really turning his attention to record production, I'm delighted to say. And another brand new set from an album which was eagerly anticipated, because the first album, 7 Year Itch, was, in my opinion, excellent. It's the new album from Protégé. It's called, well, it's called 8 Year Affair, but this track that we're championing tonight on One Extra is called Music From My Heart. Blazing Horns. Reggae. Sunday nights, 7 to 9 on One Extra with me, David Rodigan. Welcome along.
Shots, no, no, I won't get caught up in all of the things them woulda start. The stray eye from my past won't fall victim to them kind of. I'm making music from my heart, not music for the charts, no, no. With all of the things them woulda start, the stray eye from my past won't. Oh, oh, hey. Now I see what is my responsibility. The blessings I've received, for when people they stand in front of me with their ears attentively, well then I do my best to reach them. Or if I am making music for my soul, I know my role, well then it cannot get defeated. So divine when these energies align, thoughts are from mine, so I know that I am just making music from my heart, not music for the charts. No, no, I won't get caught up in all of the things that would have started. No, no, I won't get caught up.
8-year affair. I'm seriously impressed, and I hope you are too. The track from it there, my protege. Music from my heart with those blazing horns. Such a good album. Reggae on BBC Radio 1 Extra, wherever you're listening around the UK or indeed around the globe. Online, live and direct. And if your crazy, wacky schedule means that you're still on ballistic overdrive, even on a Sunday evening, remember you can always listen again on the BBC Radio 1, on the BBC Radio iPlayer. Case of Rewind and Come Again Selector. Piece of vinyl. Do you know there are some people who've never actually seen a piece of vinyl? No, seriously. I mean, it's, yeah, tiny kids. What's that? It's a piece of vinyl, has a hole in the middle. It's called a gramophone record. And believe it or not, they are still manufacturing gramophone records. And this is a real find. Sufferation 1969. Justin Hines and the Dominoes with Justin. Calm down, Rogers. Just Hines and the Dominoes with Tommy McCook and the Supersonics, produced by the late, great Duke Reed. They found this in the vaults of Duke Reed. I've never heard this song before, but I'm going to play it on vinyl a little bit later on. Can't wait.
I heard this playing at a dance in Genoa a few weeks ago, and I just thought, oh my gosh, I'd forgotten how brilliant this record is from Burning Spear. Swell headed, deep and heavy on One Extra.
He's a lucky thing I never get, swell headed. He's a lucky thing I never get, swell headed. And started to run, run, run. I will never run away. And started to run, run, run. I will never run away. Do you hear?
You out of the way that I saved your life.
You saved his life?
I did.
That's impressive.
He'll never thank me though.
Oh no.
He's a douchebag.
He's an ass.
No, because he's a douchebag. You know what sound it makes if you throw him in the water? Do you know? Do you know? Douche.
I don't get this.
What?
The thermal monitor.
What about it?
Hit it.
Huh? People, sorry.
Wow. Just wow. All your uranium cells are gone. Too.
I don't know how that's possible since it wasn't even running.
Look, come here. Just leave it there. Animal director?
No.
Why not?
I have plans for it.
Are they big plans?
Single throne, so I better me just wander the road and see what one, not a bedrock or a pillar.
Space jumping.
Whoa.
The cavern down here.
Yep.
I get a call from it.
McGregor connection on one X.
That's
Chino McGregor. We played Steve McGregor's new single in the first hour. And once again, a reminder that on Robert Ranks' show this Sunday night at Le Clark, you can listen to their father, Freddie McGregor, in conversation with Robbo. That, of course, samples brilliantly an old Heptones classic. We got to do some live party time, style and fashion. Now, Casper, on your case like Perry Mason. Casper's love of reggae music is reflected in this forthcoming track, which will hit the streets late spring, early summer. So he's given it to us as an exclusive here on One Extra. Let the rush kick in. Casper, in a different styling.
Haven't even gone through all his books yet. Starting with one I'm gonna give away. You should stream this thing.
What?
Me thrusting into you mightily. And then falling asleep.
Yeah, that's what you're about to do.
Yep.
What?
Falling asleep.
You got what?
Well, yeah.
What are you then, don't you?
Yeah, well, not that bad, my bedtime, yeah, yeah.
Your bedtime's my bedtime.
The fall off me. Spring. Thank you, you did.
Thanks for the warm welcome. I think I'm gonna have a nosebleed. It's all getting very nuts.
Goddamn fucking better leave me alone.
The foundations of New Broadcasting House are trembling.
Yeah, I'm on the highest mountain, yet I feel so high. I'm on top of the world, now watch me touch the sky. Heart of a lion, I won't lose, I win. I don't fear it. I'm on the highest mountain, yes, I feel so high. I'm on top of the world, now watch me touch the sky. Heart of a lion, I won't lose the win. I don't fear anything, now let the rush begin. Let the rush begin.
Rodders, dub place at Fabric. Easy, Mr. Jam, I know you're fading this one. Toddler, big up yourself.
Oh, I didn't know you could put these in barrels.
Yeah. I think you can stack them, can you?
Yeah.
They have to, okay, the same breed.
Right.
But, yeah. Like, from the same genetic pool type thing. Good avoid there.
You on your server, Dan?
Yeah. And that will rock soon.
Let the rush kick in. There you go, Casper and the party squad. BBC Radio 1 Extra Stories at 9 through 10 tonight. Twin B on the case with
Well, in-depth look at the work of Rita Ora, and then, of course, at 10 o'clock, your date, Mama Africa. DJ Edu, Destination Africa, 10 p.m. to 2 a.m. Guests, DJ Miser from South Africa and King Alfred and Shanky from Zimbabwe, dropping the stuff in the studio. Plus, Afrobeats Top 5 and the DNA Mix. And Scarb Original with the extra talent in the show from 1 a.m. Whoa, 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 Destination whoa, whoa, Mama Africa, yeah. DJ Edu tonight, 10 p.m. to 2 a.m. Large. Alicia Keys, like you've never heard her before. You know she loves reggae. And you know she loved this remix. And you know what? He doesn't even know her name.
Okay, to you too. Okay.
She looks different, but she's not wearing her work
clothes. I like when you say okay.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Stop doing your comments, James. Like, okay.
Oh, what did you say? Oh, yeah.
What's the other one?
What was his name? It was Mos Def, right, in the video?
fucking not remotely interested in Alicia Keys. What a wonderful video, what a wonderful song. I believe Alicia's father's Jamaican. Her love of reggae music, well, we all know that. And somebody else who loves reggae music is this lady. From Barbados.
Why you have your intro up?
Stars in urban my what? And their
love your intro.
Is it still up? Oh, yeah. What an idiot. My bad.
That's why he's like, okay.
Oh, instead of saying just okay, tell me. There you go. Alright. Ain't no intro now. At least someone came on and freaking said something. The noobs. Smash B.E. 911
is the critical emergency. Oh my god. Better run,
run, run. Come and charge with the 143. Yeah, yeah. Told me this one was mine. Such a beautiful life. Now it's done, 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 and his love is not me. Yeah. And out of the air, I see where he's me goodbye. He said he cared, but no tears in his eyes. And ask me if I'm alright. Is you blind? Like a bullet, your love hit me to the core.
Fan of Beres Hammond. Sweet, wouldn't she? No Love Allowed, Rihanna. Alicia Keys before that. Reggae vibes on Wexter. Stand by for some vinyl.
Diamond. All my life I want money and power.
Slight Color Slash, the is it?
This is the sound of One Extra.
This is the Colonia alongside Chronic.
Our colleagues I don't want them. Brother Jay and Kabaka go calm them.
Hey. I am
this space, we don't want this space. We want what tool takes away a cue by the way? The stick with the ball won't be me.
Laughing, peace soup in a war with me troops in a war. None of them can take Rastafi laughing. I mean, no worry, when me a worry myself. Me see a fiend as a warrior shelter. Stand firm like Iraq or Gibraltar. None of them now go if me see a warrior falter. Shout out, travel, I know. Stumble now, buffer.
So leave me be. Me no itch up on me yard or watch TV screen. Me dep on the front line and this me come find me. I'm an officer responsibility. See me actions, me objectives and me known so. Make a wrong step and see how quick them denounce you. But I still have the eye federal. Me officer step around means for me it them surround you. All Ethiopia me happy there. Move fast like Bobo on a Saturday. Nappy head, car keys, suit, happy patchy leg. This ya Apache, ya inbound as an Nazi dress.
Start ya gravel, I no stumble, no baffle, I ya still a see soldier man.
Them should have known.
I am strong and me happy, but now laugh with nobody. I ya still a see soldier man.
In army gear, four stripes for my arm is clear. So hang on, I no have no fear. Them woulda see me M-bomb, but a jaw on me armor here. Coulda you near Osama, this arm appear. Them have we up in a Rayman, a demand my sheer. From Jamaica to Ghana, every square inch, every corner. Every crevice is catchy message. We carry the fire, eat up like the Mojave. Then unpick the army, fi contradict my guy. From the land of freedom fighters, readers, writers, I lead the king shall guide us.
Jaja gravel, I no stumble, no baffle, I ya still a see soldier man. I am strong and be happy, but now laugh with nobody. I ya still a see soldier man.
Yo, from the parliament and Moses, it's a call of duty, absolutely. Stand up for what's right, excuse me. How you think you're faster? You're right, I'm the master. You must be stupid to think that our lungs are disorder. Hold up, soon we can have the top push. I don't know you're evil. It is when the time to reach a root on. Hear them, I plumb on the sound. Still in my fight, but I'm lost. I'm singing in my head, I love you.
Jaja gravel.
New music on BBC Radio 1 Extra. Feeling that big time. Emails david.rodigan@bbc.co.uk. It's called Selassie Soldier on a new label to me from Jamaica, Royal Order Music. The voices of Chronix, Sizzler, Protege, and Kabaka Pyramid. Got some serious mentions about Mother Africa in that song, and as usual, Sunday nights here on One Extra, DJ Edu, Destination Africa, 10 p.m. to 2 a.m. This is a piece of vinyl. Number 13 of a limited edition of 600. Just been pressed on the Duke record label, a song which I've never heard before, a double A-side in my opinion, from Justin Hines and the Dominoes. Sufferation 1969. So what, we're in a triple dip now, recession, hard times, do we feel it? Of course we do, the people on the street. Well, A song about how it was back in Jamaica in 1969, Justin Hines and the Dominoes. And I'm going to take this over here to a thing called a turntable. And if you listen keenly, this is how it used to be in sound system. A selector would scratch the needle and blow the dust off the needle. And then he'd cue it up and roll it in, which is what you're going to hear right now. Are you ready for the roll in? Are you ready for the roll in? Here we go. We roll it in like that. And the selector says,
is that shrimp?
Brand new. Justin Ice. So we pull up and we wheel and we peel and we come again from the top to the very last drop.
Okay, what are you doing right now?
Oh, my.
Yeah.
Live
stream. No, and at Spawn. What are you?
Oh, you've not seen Spawn, have you?
Separation. No, I'm watching your stream right now.
Yeah, but you haven't. What am I doing? Hacking the shit out of this. So this is Spawn, dude, right? This is the castle.
Yeah.
Damn sexy.
And what are you doing under it?
It's gonna be, it's like floating. This is gonna be a big void down here. Around all this. There's gonna be like four drawbridges coming out north, south, east and west. They're going across the east end. Nah, it's alright, man. I'm using Voxel, so. And now, gents. Down, keep clean. Tickle can, because he's the moderator on the server. Yeah, so all I'm doing, dude, is like this was obviously a square block of rock underneath the spawn. I rolled it in hard, like the outside out, and now I'm just sort of hacking the shape out of it, sort of like this side. Shaping it, trying to shape it. She's doing too bad. And now, I'm going to be banning people from a stream.
Sufferation 1969. Reissued for the first time. I've never heard that record before. And a few years ago, I was in a dance, and one of the traditional sound system selectors was playing, and I came up, and it was two turntables, and I handed him a pair of headphones for him to use, and he just looked at me and handed them back. Why would he need a pair of headphones? Well, you can understand his name, Lloydie Coxon, the champion of sound system culture in this country, and he will be appearing, if you're listening in Italy right now, for the first time.
He's dealing with it.
Outer National on the 9th of March in Bologna at Sottoteto. That'll be a night, because they love their roots rock reggae over in Italy. And wherever you're listening around the globe, great to have you with us. And the email address, if you want to request tunes and so on, david.brodigan@bbc.co.uk. Now let's go to some homegrown gear, some brand new, fresh off the market stall. This is a band from Birmingham. They are called the One Eye Band. And this is all about, well, what it's like when the bailiff knocks on your door.
I don't have no money picking nobody. Nobody beat off my door at morning time, you know. So I'm not no money for nobody. Mr.
You're talking to me or him?
What?
You're talking to me or him?
Talking to who? I'm not talking to anyone.
A while ago.
You what?
A while ago.
A while ago, dude. What's the point of having the conversation now when it was like 5-10 minutes ago that I said it?
Because I'm tired.
Go to bed then. Asleep.
I'm good.
Loads to cut out.
On their debut album for 2 years.
West.
They're called the One-Eyed Band. They're from the Midlands.
This is what all I said.
That track, Mr. Bates.
I'm starting to shrimp.
Dude, just will you leave it? Because I'll bang it. I don't want people in my stream fucking things up. Just will you just leave it?
Yeah.
There's no need for it.
Yeah.
Both of you.
Destination Africa.
I don't have nobody in my fucking
stream. Africa. This is dynamic, and those days in Nairobi.
Sorry.
No.
It's okay. Too much. Fighting with this wire just.
Wait, what?
Fighting this wire. This wire has a bad connection. I gotta go get another plug from my mic. It keeps like if you put it, the plug itself or pull on the wire, it'll disconnect and reconnect real quick. Like,
that sucks.
Hearing it disconnect and connect through my speakers.
Disconnect! Connect! Disconnect! Connect!
Not really Minecraft, bro.
My popping sound's fixed on Minecraft now, since I did a audio update. Sorry about that.
Thanks, Chris.
No matter where you come from, you
black or white. Supposed to be like studying today, bro. Oh, I got one thing I gotta study anyway. Congo is too for the people.
watch my log and get it with like a giant lag spike or something.
Probably.
If it logs in. I want to redo the spawn.
Are you at spawn?
Yeah. That's just you flying around.
Can a piston move a furnace?
Oh,
no, I don't think a piston can move a furnace.
Is that really Cory?
Yep.
I got no jetpack, but...
Hold on.
So I died last time I drowned and lost everything. Or no, I got knocked off the edge by an airman in the end. Wow, is this really necessary?
Necessary? What?
I'm just curious if we're over the chamber. The sorting system.
That's a lot
of
stuff. Yeah.
Should have set up like a method advocator though, because like we're wasting so much
obble and stuff.
Yeah.
But come over here.
You at? Oh, wait. Which way did you go?
Behind
you. Oh, I didn't see your name.
You see what it's uncovering right now, right?
Yeah. Oh, damn.
You can see diamonds. Damn stream.
You can see what? Diamond.
Yeah. Look over here.
Oh yeah, I see him there.
Come this way.
Holy hell.
No, there's actually more on the wall.
Yeah, I see him.
Yeah.
You did say it needed to be bigger.
Yeah.
Are you going to
be piping in,
Lizzie? No, not yet.
Alright, let's figure into the going to the top.
Well, no, I'm actually, I found a way that I can do it, but the problem is that it all needs to be set with no open spaces first. Dan, I'm going to jump to the other channel this time.
That's what I do, there's not really a lot of talking going on.
Alright.
If it gets too much, then...
No, shrimp.
Roots rock reggae. Well, it's my first show, my new home here at the BBC.
Did you set the lights on a light switch when you put the switch up?
No, I didn't. Back again next Sunday, 7 through to 9,
with more great reggae music. Still to come, though, purposely to put the delay on it. Every light has like a half a second. This week is latency. Then you gotta make them flicker on and off. On
breakfast, of course, tomorrow morning as well. Look at the electrical one, dude. Right here.
So is that gonna go all the way to void?
What, the...
Bedrock?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm gonna dig it out. Just have void.
What'd you... What now?
What'd you do to me?
What do you mean?
Did it drain in? Something
like that? Oh, dude, that's the... Calm crack.
How'd that affect me? Do anything.
two of them.
The place around here is soon gonna be starting on Wisp.
Mind your base, Bill. Oh, man, when Wisp starts spawning, everyone's gonna be knowing about them.
Nobody's gonna be going to Jekyll Cars anymore.
Boomcraft, I don't think, spawn wisps that often. It's more of, you know, like when you get poisoned or something. Look at that chest.
The mining turtle.
What's in it?
What's in it? From the dungeon. Ooh! Aqua Affinity 1.
Well.
But
all this is going according to the blueprint. Gotcha. And notice what I use for the walls.
Yeah. This is basically what you did to that one guy's.
What is that? Construction fall?
Yeah.
A whole lot easier, and it's reinforced. I mean, it's not as strong as a reinforced stone. It's pretty dang. It's explosion resistant.
So what do we need to undo the nuke?
Nothing. We just need a wrench.
As you do.
We just gotta have a place. It's more hooking it back up than anything. But that's right.
It's just a design, dude. It's kind of like as if it's suspended sort of thing, you know?
Where's that electric one?
Because it's kind of got a magical feel. It's meant to have a
magic. Look in the tools one.
I checked it out. I don't know if I'm the original.
Extra, extra, hear all about it. This is one extra, the universal sound of reggae music. Extraordinary bass lines, extraordinary rhythms. Spread the reggae love. Reggae and Dub Sundays, 7 till 9. On one extra. And
follow us. Oh, what in the world?
Stay up to speed with what we're doing. Here on one
weird.
Extra.
I glitched it. I'm glitching out.
Oh, it's the lights.
And Twitter, one extra. Four to the floor. Okay, here's a song that was championed by Zane Lowe when it first came out. And, Elton did a combo, didn't he? At the Grammys. This is my favorite mix, the Shy FX Aki and Solfege mix. Aki and Sal.
And all the coolant cells, like, near perfect.
The A-team, Ed Sheeran. Shy FX.
All the coolant cells we gotta remove.
What a song.
I'm like trying to move everything and you just.
Ow.
You're drowning.
I really am.
So I would need to get some quantum on me. We need to get these nukes hooked back up so we can run a mass fabricator. Make some quantum armor that we can drown it.
There's more down there, dude.
Where?
I'm stuck on these friggin' lights.
Yeah, damn
right.
The drown.
I'm not worried about that, we're gonna get those back soon.
Well, if we got everything off bottom, then we're good. Trying to get out of.
Right.
Anything else on the ball?
It will eventually stop there.
I got two of the overclocked heat, and could be, I think, 8. Something like that.
I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 of them.
Got 14 of 50, so we're good. thought there was less than that, but I guess not. I got almost all the wounds, so we were out of here, and the odds were empty. I think we're good, though. Well, for Mark, one of the nuclear reactors filled up one MFSU. No problem. Now you'll have to use that light wrench at this point. I got it. I have inventory room. My inventory's empty. I'll put it away. Yeah. Okay. Get over here. No, I'll take the. I gotta like play music constantly. I get feedback through my headphones.
You know what time it is?
It's a time of discovery.
This is BBC Radio One Extra Stories.
Discover more.
Discover more.
Yo, I'm Twin B, and this is Access All Areas. This month from Radio 1 Extra and our sister station Radio 1, it's all about Access All Areas. We might have mentioned it, giving you a chance to see what goes on behind the scenes here at the station.
I'm actually avoiding the crystals now.
Where you'll find loads of videos of DJs and staff wearing headcams, and even questions being answered about what it's like to work in the industry.
Quartz crystal.
I don't even know what that means. Day dot in her
career. The artist in question was personally signed by Jay-Z.
I just know they're not helping
you. He's already scored three number one singles in the UK, and is now nominated for three Brit Awards.
You can, if you don't mind that. Goody ass look.
What else can you do?
Nothing.
They are actually completely useless.
Yeah.
Not really, there's no use for them in game.
Over
the next 60 minutes, you'll hear what happened when I spent the day with her. Is she here in London? I'm sharing a car to the
working on it, though.
Snooping the dressing room. Do we get to watch how this happens? No?
Okay, cool. We'll leave her.
Meeting her entourage and fans.
But I can't believe she, like, recognised. It's just so surreal, like, every time. It's like, hey! I'm like, oh my god!
And finally, going on stage at London's Shepherd's Bush Empire.
Save me! It's showtime!
No turning back now, Rita. No turning back.
This is Access All Areas with Rita Ora on BBC Radio 1 Extra.
I'm just kind of using this because I don't know if you noticed this or not, Chad. But come out here. Look over the house.
What in the world? Wait, you're gonna quarry the house?
Yep. Yeah.
I know, I wouldn't watch it too. Devastate. Wait, you already started?
No.
No.
The problem though?
What's that?
That freaking distorting machine's down below.
What are we gonna do for our power? Can we move over to MFSU and start a charging?
Dude, I haven't hooked up anything yet.
Well, we need to put solar panels like temporarily over where it's safe, because we're gonna need power for you.
All I have right now is blue power.
Yeah, we're gonna need a. Put up some power sources over there outside the quarry, because it's going to eat the power source and the wires, and we're not going to have any power.
No, it's not going to eat the wires. It should spit them right back.
Well, I mean, like, just pull them out and just connect the
power. Oh, all that stuff's already disconnected. I've already taken just about everything out. I mean, I might have missed a thing or two, but...
So what are we powering all the cords off? The geothermal?
Yeah.
Ah, never mind then.
Holy crap, I've got so much coal.
Is that a creeper?
Yeah.
He like you or something?
Yeah, he just like showed up to me when I was today.
But yeah, there's still some stuff left in here.
Can I test my sword on you?
No.
Didn't you already test your sword?
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought so.
I was wondering if you'd say yes or no.
I do want these though, Chad.
What's that?
I do want these though.
What's that?
There's four barrels full of marble.
Where are they at?
Right up here.
It's so easy.
Wow, that's a lot to move.
Well, I do have an idea.
What, pump it out?
You got a pick on you?
Yeah.
I got a badass pick on me, so I'll come do it.
Get that right there.
Where do we need it down by the marble?
No, bro. Bring it right over here. Because we've got so much of that, I'm just going to put it in the back. So just drop it right here and I'll start dropping the stuff in there.
Okay, so it's Twin here. I've just jumped in the whip. I'm in a home side of the city. We are in West LDN.
Yes.
Rita Ora.
Hello.
Access all areas. So you have to be open with us today, Miss Rita Ora.
I know, it's all
Alliance.
About telling you the truth of
what
how
your FPS right now?
The process goes towards the show, isn't it?
It's a very exciting 74.
It's
the very first sold-out London show. Are you nervous?
Go, girl.
Silly question.
I'm so nervous. This is my home show. This is the first of the London show. Okay. We have two shows in London. Because we were originally meant to have just one.
Yeah.
But it sold out really quickly. So we were like, let's see if we can send another one out.
Okay, someone's popular.
So we did. And I was like, yes! Bam! Yes! Woo 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 woo!
Go, girl. We've met you nice and early. I've got to say, your car is smelling sweet.
Yeah, I'm getting my
Thank
50.
You, Vanilla.
Slight disappointment that you're rolling on your own. We thought it was going to be a party.
You're going to start taking them out, right?
No, it's only 2 o'clock. What time? I don't even know what time it's only.
Spacebar. Hold spacebar and right click.
I don't really roll with a whole entourage.
Ah.
You
know,
the first reality is at 2 o'clock, you're not partying. I'm crushed.
No, I always am on my own. Do you know that? Isn't that weird?
You spend a lot of time on your own then?
Yeah, I do. I spend a lot of time on my own when I go to from city to city. But, you know, my band and my friends on the road with me. But I don't really travel with a whole bunch of people.
Okay. Who do you spend the most time with when you're traveling?
Probably Kyle.
Okay.
Who is my best friend, who also works as my stylist.
Okay. Yeah.
And I don't know, he's just always with me. He helps me with everything. He's like the best person.
So without a doubt, we'll be bumping into Kyle today.
100%. I think he's wearing
something. Oh crap! You took the bag. Put it back real quick and. Oh, thank
and
goodness.
Who else makes the Rita Ora entourage?
I'm gonna have to come all the way back there.
So you got him and you got my sister.
Yeah.
And then you got.
He's also your manager as well.
Yeah, he's also my manager. I'm a day to day, and she is my older sister, so she kind of just keeps me in check all the time.
Fair enough.
Then you have my two girls, Angela and Natasha, who are my BV singers.
Okay.
But also kind of just the coolest.
Yeah.
And then my band, who I've been playing with since I started to do live shows, since Coldplay.
Okay. Okay. So those guys, obviously outside your sister, properly become your family then. You have to kind of get on with them straight away and stuff.
Yeah, and I try and stick to the same people. I don't like changing up, you know, band members. Because it's all about the relationship and the energy you have on stage and the connection. And that's why I've kept the same band since the beginning almost. And we just have fun on stage and we rock out to Biggie. We have a good time. And, you know...
Boo.
Are we good to go?
Oh my god.
We're live.
Okay, lovely. Alright, I'll hand you over to Twin. Cheers. Just putting it through to the desk. So we're all good?
That's a lot of marble.
Bit of labyrinth on One Extra, Sarah Jane. And I told you that February is all about access all areas, didn't I? Hey, hey, hey.
Access all areas.
Hi, Twin.
Yep, what's going on?
How are you doing? You alright?
I'm good, yes, I'm alright, you're right.
Now, you are creating a documentary right now.
Yes.
A moment in history.
Mm-hmm.
What is that documentary going to be called?
It's Rita Ora, AAA, Access All Areas, hashtag Rita Ora, three capital A, she just screamed at me, AAA, so it's Rita Ora,
So basically, you're making a documentary, Access All Areas, so 24 hours in a day in the life of Rita Ora.
Yes. Here she is. Hold on. Are you ready to talk to Isha?
I don't know. I'm not quite sure.
Rita Ora.
What's up, Sarah?
How's it going, mate?
I'm good. I'm a bit nervous. I'm like just screaming at everybody, pretending like I'm not nervous.
So what is like 24 hours like with you when you're kind of going through all this madness? Obviously, you're nominated for 3 Brits. That's all happening. What have you been doing with Twin B?
Right now, I've just been in the car, and the first thing he said was, no entourage. I was like, no, man, I roll on my own. I've always been on my own. So we're on the way to the venue now. I kind of feel a bit sorry for him, in all honesty.
Why is that?
Because it's just like, he thinks I'm partying all the time. And really, I do like to have a little party and a But, you know, not right now, when I'm a bit nervous. Probably later at 5 o'clock.
So say, for example, if we were hanging out and we got up first thing in the morning, what would be, like, breakfast for Rita Ora?
Cereal with bananas in it.
Nice.
A little bit of Diana Ross in the background.
Oh,
maybe
cute.
With a little bit of Luther Vandross to warm us up.
Yeah.
Then put a little bit of 2 Chainz on.
Oh, okay. So you go from happy to getting aggy.
Yeah. So you can get your spirit warm and getting ready.
Okay.
And then we get in the car and probably go straight to the venue and just have a little sound check. But it's never really a great sound check. We always just mess around.
Okay.
And then just chill until showtime.
And is it nice that the thought of sharing your sort of like life, some private elements of it as well, with your fans as well, who are getting involved in the hashtag and...
Yeah, it's nice. I love this whole thing of everybody knowing everybody's business nowadays.
Whenever I sort of watch what you're up to on Twitter or ever I speak to you, I get really excited. I think, oh, you just make me feel excited about life. So you're having you're having a good time. So I think it's nice that we're doing this whole Access World Areas with
more
you
marble.
Because you can spread the excitement of your own life onto others.
Yeah!
Yeah, boy!
We out here, guys!
We're doing this. So if you want to keep the conversation going, hashtag Rita Ora AAA. Listen, good luck with your gig
Thank
tonight,
you very much.
London Town. And,
thank you very much.
And I'll probably see the Brits.
Yes, all right, I'll see you there, beautiful lady.
Yes, girlfriend. Bye, Twin.
All right.
Bye, Rita.
Bye.
So that is all happening the 17th of February, which is Sunday, a few days before the Brits. Do you know where I used to live in?
Yeah, West Side.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, and I used to come out over here. I used to go to that pub over there sometimes. Don't tell my dad, he'd kill me.
obviously, you just had orange juice, so.
Yeah, orange juice. Yeah.
I think the house is clear.
I used to look at who was performing, and I would see, like...
Who were some of the names that you saw?
And I was...
Outside?
Everybody. I remember I saw Fatboy Slim.
Yeah.
I remember I saw Trey Songz once. I remember I saw Adele there.
Yeah. But let's talk about now, because we're driving past.
Oh
Sheffield
my god,
Bush
my
Empire.
Name is out.
Look, your
name's
in lights. 5th and 6th of February.
Wall of food.
Sold out. West London.
Wow. Isn't that weird? How it's just like. And it's cool because I swear, you don't understand. I used to like stare at it and wish that I would.
All these chiseled stone bricks.
And it's such a great venue. I
Why
saw so
there?
Many people perform.
Chiseled stone
bricks. I saw Beyonce perform there when she did her 4-hour
show. Stone bricks.
I saw just a whole bunch of people. I haven't gone for ages, but.
Server
you know, to
now.
Me, it's more of an iconic place than. How many people it seems.
Oh, who's those are.
Yeah, of course. Right, so we are about
Thank
to
you.
The venue, but we've got to dodge people who have been waiting there.
Fine, but you can have them all.
Yes. Yeah, exactly. So I'm going to put my hood up because I haven't got any makeup on.
Okay.
And I don't want to
probably take your cold too, Wes.
That's it, triple A. It's
triple
real
A.
All the way. No
you asked for it, so
yeah,
it's real
yeah.
All the way.
Can I have that canvas bag
there?
Wow.
So. Pretty much now, all we have to do is burrow out the rest of it. At this point, I'm letting them dig out to bedrock.
Yeah.
And then, can you see right here? Like, I used the builders to go two down. So, like, two levels of dirt right here all the way across.
Yeah.
And then this right here is double half slab.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go all the way across with that, and I don't think we can possibly use any more room.
Yeah.
This is gonna be the biggest ass place ever.
I'm Twin B, and it's
bigger than your castle.
You what? We
rolled. Probably bigger than your castle.
If you want to get involved on Twitter, you can tweet us at 1XTRA
and use the hashtag
Rita Aura.
The place that he's building now is probably bigger than the castle at spawn.
Oh. Alright, so we jumped out the car and we were bombarded by a couple of fans who were on this team from early.
Oh, how they drew those pictures.
Probably
so
bigger.
It
actually is bigger.
They interrupted by
a
fan base.
Have you been to it?
To me, it's all like fans.
What?
I know they just want
to
show
their appreciation.
To
a new place?
I love talking to them. My security gets mad at me.
It's basically his place.
Dude, it's 97 by 97.
Yeah. Does it ever become an inconvenience? Because I saw the fact that you had to rush and you got a huge show to do. And there's two people in front of you with pictures of Jordan. It's like, are they not slightly interrupting your day?
It's about, it's getting close to the reaction thing.
But, you know, you just have to give them a quick time and then you have to
all that work.
And I'm like, look at this face, you know, I have to fix my face.
Yeah.
Was good practice.
On stage looking like
Cruella
DeVille. You know what I mean?
But just
so right now the stone walked up, it looks epic because it's just a dome and a perfectly square ground.
Yeah. Are you just going to leave it here and let it mine out?
Yep. Dude, and all the slimes, dude, we definitely gotta build a slime farm down there.
Oh yeah. They're even falling into the nuclear reactor.
So we've slid in past the fans that have been here for a long time.
Yes.
We're now backstage.
So apparently on top of everything else, on top of the slime chunk as well.
Is that a dress or is that like
it's
a curtain for the whole venue?
No.
Massive. Huge.
It's basically a big, big, puffy...
I'm waiting for it to get
kind of
done so I can get three times
that. That you put on top of the outfit that's underneath.
Yeah.
And it's for the intro, and then I take it off.
So what do we need to work on now?
So it's only for one song, and I can't move in it.
Basically,
so
just
the
things with the builder to build that across so that we can
now
get underneath and start building the equipment.
So everybody's here. So we've
the
got
problem
Christina,
is,
who does my styling,
like
works
Christina.
With Kyle.
The problem is
Natalie,
that all the stuff that we really need
Paul,
to build is where the house is right now.
Okay.
Yeah.
We've got Connor, who is my boy, who just films everything.
And I mean, all that needs to be done is turned on. It actually, it's going to leave two things we'll have to dig out.
It's also very hot.
Yeah.
But,
I mean.
This is just the usual climb.
Yeah.
But there's more.
What you should do is with all those electrical engines that you're running right now, just stick them, like once they're done, put the quarry over this one and stick all of those electrical engines.
You can't.
So your whole
you go
before
they just blow up.
In your life as well.
Yeah.
How has that been? Like,
you're
going to
max power then.
It's a lot.
Your dad, happy.
That is max power.
Is
this max power?
They love the fact that
they're
happy.
Anything
you
else, and the pipe starts floating.
They're not used to it. But
I mean, I guess I could run them on different pipes, but.
My mom's like, I've never had so many people. I've never been so popular in my life. No, but, yeah, it's funny how you see things kind of change. And that's why you kind of have to keep your family around. You see people.
We should have
kind
just ran it though, just with an energy link. We should have just made an energy link.
You just know the difference now nowadays, but
you lose power.
So everybody's invited.
I mean,
yeah.
I'm overdoing it with what I have right now.
As well, and your sister's gonna be
yeah.
here soon.
Yeah.
Like, there's really no reason for that.
She's gonna
be for all three of those.
Oh god, I'm not gonna be in the room. I don't even wanna hear what she's gonna say.
She's part of the team as well.
She is, and she's also very.
And this one's ready to go. You think I should start?
No filter when it comes to
Rita. Yeah, I would
do it. I'm gonna let you try on these outfits.
It's time.
I'm gonna
read
some more.
Do we get to watch how this happens?
No, you're not gonna watch
me
take my clothes off.
Oh, I gotta watch this.
Okay, cool. We'll leave then.
But the reason I said energy link though is you can put like one solar panel here or whatever it is, an energy link, and then connected to the cord, and the cord's gonna only let how much of the power it needs through.
This is a, like, fake family. This is actual blood.
And so once more,
yeah,
it'll take.
Yeah, yeah. Rita's older sister.
Forgot to get a letter.
Is this all weird for you?
You might want to take all that water out of the thing.
The show with you.
What?
Yeah, I can imagine. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Everything else.
Yeah, I mean, like, your little sister who you grew up with and probably kind of.
Whatever.
It's been, yeah, it is a bit weird, but because if you're in it.
Yeah.
Kind of just roll with it and it gradually grows, whereas to everyone else it seems like all of a sudden.
Yeah, of course, because I guess you've seen what happened in the shadows before Rita got exposed and signed by Rock Nation.
Work behind the hard work and stuff like that. So.
So you say hard work. When would you say the hard work started? Like, no one's probably seen more than you and Mum and Dad, obviously.
And you actually, you were there for our first show.
Yeah. But did you expect to get to this stage? Did you always have the confidence? Even though Rita's here, be honest. You can say no if you didn't believe.
Of course I did, but it feels different when you're in a. When you're somewhere and it's sold out and somebody else is not coming on next.
Yeah.
Or you're not at a festival and then somebody else is going to perform. It's like, literally, they're just here for her.
It's your actual sister, Alina.
I know, it's crazy.
Weird. And you stepped into a management role with your sister as well. Was that something that you found important to do?
I think it just happened naturally because I would help her make decisions before she even had a manager.
Big old fancy tree.
And she would just ask me, what should I do about this, what should I do about that, so just
kind of forward.
Happened naturally, I guess.
Yeah, and I guess this
was not
just a change for Rita's life, but a change for you and your whole family.
If not, I think I'm going to get it back.
Recognised me outside.
I saw that.
Taking pictures with me.
Yeah, I just saw that on Twitter, so you become famous by default as well.
I know, I've got 18,000 followers and I've only ever tweeted like 5 times.
Did I get up wrong?
So explain, because it happens more where family members get involved in some management and label. What would you say are the advantages of that?
Probably.
Okay, good, you get everything out of your secret chest.
Mm-hmm.
So it just eliminates the decision making process. I've got no filter, apparently, according to Rita.
Are there times where, as a manager, it's hard to kind of separate your sister from.
I don't know, it's going to reach all the way up there.
Just like to another team member, can you please deal with this one? Because. We're not talking right now.
What do you got?
I'm going to leave you to do management stuff, because I guess this is
wait,
a busy
what do you
work
have power in the electrical engine?
A proud and busy
day. What?
Amazing.
What do you have power in these electrical engine?
Cool.
She has that one. You got the hook up to the top one?
Now, hello, Twin B.
I'm going to... Oh, God.
I'm good, are you alright?
Yeah, I mean, what's going on?
I'm actually currently stood in Rita Ora's dressing room. Yeah.
Yeah.
What's it like?
It's glamorous in its own little way. It's nice, as in she's made it nice with her outfits and the people and the entourage.
Right. Okay. And what has she done to the place to make it look a bit more glamorous?
There's fruit, but the fruit, if you're honest, Rita, the fruit.
Oh, are you not even using
image? I just put them organically.
Oh, okay.
Bless it.
Okay. Cool. Not great looking.
Does she have anything a little bit special before she goes on stage that you're
aware of? Yeah, I meant to, but.
If I'm gonna let you ask her.
Okay, yeah, pass me
on
over.
The radio one,
yeah, just keep going off.
Hey, babe, how are you?
Hi, Scott.
You okay?
I'm better now.
I'll fix it,
So, Twin's making this documentary about you, right?
Yeah.
Yes, yeah, he is.
Will you do me a favour? Don't let him hear this.
Okay, go on. Right. Hold on, let me go into my little shower.
Thanks.
Go on.
Can you hear us?
No.
Okay, right. Just to spice up the documentary a bit, we'd quite like it if you can make stuff up when he's interviewing you.
Yeah.
Okay, right. So can I give you a couple of ideas?
Yeah.
Okay, so he'll be like, so what do you like to do? I'm imagining he'll ask, what do you like to do in your spare time when you're relaxing and not on tour?
There they go.
Just say that you're really into taxidermy, like stuffing animals. Okay, and say you've got a massive collection of them in your living room.
Oh, poor Silverwood Tree.
Is that all right?
Yeah.
Just shave the top of it off.
Just
a little cut, please.
Into stuffing animals. That's your hobby, okay?
Okay, done.
Why are there sugar canes up here? That was me. Man. Hope we get a sapling. Yeah.
I literally love guys for these freaking fun. Die, motherfucker!
Yeah, reinforce. Yeah, I know it's crazy whenever I get myself in that zone. But I know you got to remember London. Let's put them on this. And if it gets easy, ha, I feel so uneasy. It's gonna be a big chord. You'll never forget the fact that I'm yeah. We're just going to have to keep an eye on it and make sure that it doesn't overload that mini sorting machine.
Yeah.
And it sucks because I have to go to bed here pretty soon.
Yep. I hear you. Ooh, diamond. Bunch of diamonds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We should just build a giant in the middle of this void at the bottom. Make that like a computer board.
Did you know there was a gold block under your the reactor?
Yep.
By the way, I checked that out.
Why?
Yes.
This is Radio 1 Stories with Twin B hanging out backstage with Rita Ora.
Did it already start cutting down the tree?
So I'm sat watching Rita get done up. Is that what you call it?
Yeah, I'm getting a little bass on.
Yeah, it's working though. Ow, go girl.
Oh, so now you like my face.
Yeah, because... like,
oh, you didn't fall.
No, it was good. It
okay.
was... Okay. It's access all areas, so when I met Rita earlier on, it was makeupless.
Yeah.
Chilling with no makeup on.
Yeah, I was.
Yeah, I like that, keeping it real.
Thank you. I don't really want makeup on if I have to.
Isn't this like early? What's the time now? It's like 4-ish.
Yeah.
Is this the makeup for the show or is this beforehand or?
Well, the eyes are for the show, but it's because I'm doing a meet and greet. I want to meet some. I'm going to meet my fans and I've got interviews and so I just want to look like I'm alive.
Yeah, yeah. Do you feel pressure? Because now, yeah, obviously you walk out and cameras could be anywhere. So do you feel like you always have to look your best or are you at ease?
Yeah.
With being
I feel under pressure, but do you know what I feel more under pressure with?
Go on.
The fact that I've got an obsession with stuffed animals.
Okay, explain.
You know, I really love the fact that I love stuffing animals.
Okay. So do you stuff the animals yourself, or?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
What do you stuff your animals with?
You know, just things that I collect during the years.
Okay. What's your favorite animal to stuff?
Yeah, so many stacks I have of coal.
How many?
On me.
Okay.
On the stack of coal carrot as well, that's got my name written on it.
Magpies?
Okay.
What?
Because they're little.
Yeah. Strange.
You want a coal coat? You can ask me, because I have 11 stacks on me.
So, she's getting her hair made up and talking about stuffed animals. We're really getting triple A.
Do you have anywhere to charge things?
To Miss Rita Ora today. It is triple A, so we're here. Getting ready for the show. Have the nerves kicked in yet?
Okay, help put me on there.
Usually start
probably
to feel a bit...
15,
you're getting demanding from your old age.
That's when the nerves
please,
kick in.
Reporting home.
Oh, was it? Ah! See, it's what that guy tweeted, isn't it?
Do you
okay,
actually
okay,
think
okay,
I'm
okay,
crazy?
Okay.
You're
right.
Like, what?
Thank you, Mr. Scott.
Thank you.
For trying to mess up.
My documentary.
I was thinking, Mark, I ain't seen one stuffed animal since we got in here. It's really, really weird. It's strange.
In the running, British single are Rita Ora featuring Tiny Temper, R.I.P.
Can't believe you think I stole from me.
You're listening to a few days before the Brit Awards, and Miss Rita, you are nominated for a few. How is that feeling?
Yes, it feels amazing. It feels like
like ping pong.
You don't really know how to explain something
just
when you get
acknowledged.
Just one
boing, I got a torch, and then bounce up at another one.
It feels
like the coolest thing I've ever done.
Be honest with me, do you feel like when you saw the nominations, are you like, yeah, I deserve those, like, I've earned that. Do you know what I mean? Like, were you waiting thinking, I've put my grind in?
I mean, I always thought I put my grind in, but I kind of never expect anything.
It was
a big surprise to know that I got acknowledged for just, like, even my songs and Best Breakthrough, and I couldn't believe it.
Yeah. Would you say, you know, obviously going into to stage school and kind of preparing for a long time before people saw you for stardom in a weird way?
But yeah. No,
would you
I don't.
Say, like, your journey towards something like that began a long time ago?
Yeah, no, in my head, I kind of started it when I was in...
What the hell is going there?
I never thought about settling to another job. Like, it never crossed my mind to be like, what else could I be doing with my life? Like, I always just thought that this was all I would be doing. And then gradually, it just fell into place, because I just kept working at it, you know?
The stage school starts at 11, so as an 11-year-old, all I cared about was Man United, trying to get my first kiss, and that's about it. Were you focused from then? Is that what you was on? Were you at that age, like, wanting to...
But yeah, so we can get the... If we can get it filled in today with the builder.
I was like, all in the Disney...
We should have enough marble, and we should have enough dirt, I think.
Waterfall!
I just wanted to be on that stage.
I don't think it's hard with being a participant.
It will.
Yeah, and what other elements do you think are kind of like part of your journey to success? Obviously, you know, you finish school and you go home. How important was it to have your parents and your family believe that, you know, you could make it one day?
It was really important because I never enrolled into a theatre college. You know, all my friends at school were like, oh, I'm going to Intelle Conte sixth form, or like, you know, all these theatre school colleges, and I didn't want to go, you know, I wanted to sing, I just wanted to play music. So obviously it took a minute for my mum and dad to kind of accept that, so I enrolled into an A-levels college.
Yeah.
That didn't last long, but it was a lot, because there's times where I really wasn't doing anything all day, you know, and I felt down, and I felt like I was a waste, and I would kind of wake up and not do anything, and just sit in my room and write music. But they kept me going, you know, they kept me hungry and driven, and
for a lot of young people, trying to find a path in life is hard.
It is.
And you try and find that point at which everything makes sense, and it's like, yes, all
right. It's hard because you change your mind so much when you're young. You know, you always change your decisions. Like, you like something. It's like when you get a tattoo when you're young and you grow up and you just hate it.
I don't like him anymore.
You know, I've got a few tattoos on my body that me and my best friend have got, which now I'm like, why did we do that?
What are they?
Can't see them.
Okay,
thank God.
No names, though. They're not.
No, they're not names. They're just like patterns of like stars and just stupid things.
So the music thing, it made sense at what point? When was it like something you realised, like, okay, this is actually what I'm going to do for the rest of my life? Obviously, there was that period of doubt that you said.
I've been wanting to do it since I was 6 years old. You know, I got my Cinderella role in my primary school, and I felt like the Queen of Sheba. I felt like I was the best person in the room. Like, I got Cinderella. I just always in my head, it's really strange, because I know you probably won't believe me, but I genuinely never thought about doing anything else.
Wow. And you mentioned when you were 11 you wanted to be Beyonce. She knows who you are. Is that weird?
Yeah, it is weird.
Yeah, you'll keep an eye on this while I sleep. Yeah, I'll keep an eye on it. Yeah, if we can get it dug out, basically, we're gonna make like right where you are right now. Yeah, right below that is where the nuke. Well, no, I thought you were further up here. Right here is like where the nuke's gonna go. Down below.
Alright.
I'm gonna like these.
Yeah,
And I'll see you in a couple hours.
Nothing on, we strut around, we do with these.
User left your channel.
We shut it down. I wonder if you'd be able to handle me. Mental pictures, no cameras, please. You see, you, my heart is beating. You see, you, my don't know who you're trying to flag. I got my mind made up. I'm ready for you. I'm in control, but with you being a man, you don't seem to understand. I'm ready for you. I'm ready for you. Oh, I'm ready for you. So keep thinking you the man, cause it's all part of our plan. Radio 1, one extra, one more time.
It's not going to fit this being a square. This is all going to be changing. It's all going to be changing. And that's done too much. Fucking yeah. All that shit. That's done too much. All this terrain around this is just. It's going to be different. There's a lot more. You know what I mean? It's all going to be changed. Like, it's all going to be dropped down a level slightly, going out. It's going to be all customised and everything around here. A lot of work to be done.
Yeah, so it's, Aura, AAA, accessible areas. We've just entered a room which is full of people who have won competitions to meet Miss Rita Aura. And it's the first time I've experienced this whole thing. Obviously, like, loads of people wait outside of radio to meet all of our DJs all the time, and we're used to this screaming. But this was epic.
Hello.
Hello. How are you?
I'm good.
So you were the first person to meet Miss Rita Aura.
Yes.
How was the smile on your face is huge.
Yeah, amazing.
She's
yeah.
behind you. Look again.
I can't believe it.
You're still shaking a bit. And are you looking forward to the gig tonight? You seen her before?
Yes, I did. I saw her at the Inigo when she did a short gig there.
Okay.
For charity. I wanted to see her at Scala, but I didn't get a chance to meet her.
But this is the first time you've met her, though.
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, good. High five and congratulations.
Thanks very much.
Are you going to wash this hand ever again? That's the hand that took Rita Aura's hand.
Yeah, probably not.
Hello, what is your name?
Shannon Egan.
Hello, Shannon Egan. You sound like you've got an accent. So have you made a long journey to London to do
yeah,
this?
Yeah, I travelled from Dublin yesterday.
Okay, and you've just met Miss Rita Aura.
Yeah.
You are kitted out with pictures and banners and stuff ready to meet her. How big a Rita Aura fan are you?
Unbelievable.
Okay.
Like, actually, like, just idolise it to the ground. Like, I look up to everything she does. Like.
So why, out of all the artists on the planet, is Rita Aura the one you look up to the most? What is it about?
It's like the fact that she like conquered the world, especially coming from like Kosovo and everything.
Yeah.
And like the way
she's
like,
working since
like 14, trying to like groundwork and working in bars and trying to get signed and stuff. So it's a big inspiration.
So you respect her hustle?
Yeah. Definitely.
Okay. Oh, good. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Ace in for. Yeah, so we'll.
Hello?
Got about three minutes. Yeah.
Shout out to Twin B, man. He had the pleasure. He's still involved. He's still hanging out with Miss Rita Aura all day, finding out what it's like to be a superstar. And we've got Twin B on the phone. What's going on, Twin?
Yes, bruv. All day and all night, just hanging out. It's access all areas. I get to see everything.
Everything.
Well, I'm walking to a meet and greet, and I'm interrupting some fans, meeting her for the first time. So if you hear screams...
Well, right now we're still warm rails full of marble.
But here is Miss Rita Aura herself. You're live. Don't say anything naughty.
Oh, we're live. Yeah, we're live. Let's
I want extra. You're just interrupting a really busy meet and greet.
I'm so sorry, Rita.
I'm joking.
I apologize. This is Ace speaking.
Hi Ace, what's up?
I'm fine. Now I know I was your choice to hang out with you all day, but I was a bit busy and you got twins.
No, I heard you're a little bit busy.
I apologize for that.
I'm gonna say hello.
Okay, cool. Oh wow.
Just saying hi.
Now before I let you go, I've been hearing loads of things about you, Rita. Like I hear that you're in a new series on 90210. Is that true?
Oh, yes, we shot it in LA just before New Year's. Yeah.
I'm a massive fan of that show.
I love 90210 too. That was fun. Yeah, we did that. I sang R.I.P. and How We Do and a few other stuff.
So you actually played Rita Ora in 90210?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Do you plan to do some more acting?
Yeah, I love to do acting. I'm actually got a big surprise coming up and it's a good surprise. I don't even know if I can say it. I nearly ruined it.
Come on! Do you want me to guess? If I guess,
it's a big movie.
If I guess, will you say yes or no?
I'll make a noise. Can I say it?
I predict that you are going to be the next Catwoman.
No, I wish.
Alright, Wonder Woman.
No.
You are going to play Mrs. Jackson in the story of Michael Jackson.
I mean, I am Mrs. Jackson's best friend, but no.
Am I close? Are you going to be in a big movie?
Well, I'm going to say it's something to do with cars. Bye-bye now.
Ooh! Rita, enjoy the show tonight.
You guys never seem to amaze me, you know. I love you guys. Thank you for checking in.
No, we appreciate you so much. You're like...
Okay, shout out to Simone, though, because we interrupted her meet and greet.
Oh, sorry. Big up to Simone.
Big up to Simone.
Wait. Rita, get back to the fans and enjoy the show tonight. Break a leg.
Alright, love guys a lot. Have a good night.
I'm talking to a man who just got a kiss on the cheek of Rita Ora.
Yeah.
You're not even blushing.
I'm
you should
actually
be blushing
embarrassed.
Much more.
I am going red.
I've got to say, you are one of the few guys here.
I know, yeah.
To meet Rita.
One of the only guys.
So what is it that you saw or heard about her that made you feel?
Well, she's gorgeous, obviously, yeah. But the music's good. She's a great live performer, so what can I have to like?
I'm right in saying that you love her, don't you?
Yes.
I think she's met you before. She said that when she met you, I haven't seen
I've
you in 4 months.
I've met her about like 15 times.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I've been meeting her since like last February. I met her at the Enemy Awards, and then I've kind of like been going to all her shows and like all radio stations. I basically like follow her.
Your old friends then, basically,
yeah.
You and me.
But I can't believe she like recognised me. It's still so surreal, like every time. She's like, hey, I'm like, oh my god.
How did you come across Rita first?
I just saw like new acts online. Like, I searched like pages. And then I saw about Rita, and then I saw like the Jay-Z and the Beyonce link, and then I was like, I'm gonna take a listen, and I just fell in love for, like, instantly. It's so nice to get like a new UK raw talent,
yeah.
That's like urban as well, so it's so nice. But I'm so proud of her. I can't believe like she's headlining Shepherd's Bush. So crazy.
So you've seen the journey from the beginning.
Yes. Yeah. I saw it at Jazz Cafe, and there's only like 10 fans, and then now to see like a sold out show, like all for her.
You're one of the loyal ones then.
Yeah.
So where do you see headed for Rita then? Seeing as someone who's seen her from the beginning, where is it going?
Hopefully as big as possible. One of my dreams is to see her do the O2. I would love to see that. Something like
the
that.
Cool girl.
So, yeah. I'm speculating.
Yeah.
Hopefully she might support Beyonce, but
okay.
That would be hot.
That's a good one. There is no doubt in my mind you'll be there if she is.
Yes.
Well, good. Thank you very much.
Alright, thank you.
Yeah.
Can you combine two sharpness threes so you can get a sharpness four?
I don't know if you can. You mean using the anvil?
Yeah, you
have to have. If you had a sharpness 4 sword, it would counter up sharpness 3. But then it could be different in FTB, I'm not sure.
Definitely getting this haste.
You got me?
I got haste on the book. Holy crap, I can get a badass sword.
Wow. The top floor is gone.
And you're listening to Access All Areas with Rita Ora. That was Shine Your Light from 1XTRA Live 2012. If you want to get involved on Twitter, you can tweet us at 1XTRA and use the hashtag, #RitaAuraAAA.
BBC Radio 1XTRA Story. Discover more.
So back to like the start of it all in terms of Rita Ora, the singer on CDs and on MP3s.
Yeah.
And what's your first memory of actually going into the studio and your first recording?
My first ever recording was with Fraser T. Smith.
Okay.
He was working with Craig David at the time. And I did this song with Craig called Where's Your Love a very long time ago. I think I was 15. Ooh. Craig was an amazing introduction because he really helped me get free studio time and he helped me kind of adapt to that life of making music.
Yeah.
So I went into the studio with Fraser. You know, it was amazing. He did it with me for free, you know. He kind of experimented with me a little bit, and it was the first time I experienced, like, studio life.
Yeah. So to get noticed at 14 is pretty young for a singer, to be honest. How does that happen for a 14-year-old?
I don't know. I guess I was just blessed and lucky. But I think it all happens for a reason. You know, my mum put my name up for a fun fair open mic.
Yeah.
For fun, for a reason. And sitting there was producers that I ended up working with who introduced me to Craig, who then introduced me to, you know, the management that introduced me to Fraser.
Yeah.
All right. And then that time, A&R started to really kind of get involved. And then, you know, my name just kind of got around.
Yeah.
And people would come watch my show, and that's how you came to Manchester.
Yeah.
Somebody must have told you something. And
yeah.
I think it was just word of mouth, really.
As you mentioned, like, you went to stage school, you had a supportive family, so in a weird way, you probably had a lot of preparation for it.
Somebody shut up that dog.
What do you think you weren't prepared for?
I wasn't prepared for...
Yeah,
it
should be quiet in a second.
Hey, you're a foreign one to tell, you know?
You're a little
this
Mexican now,
yeah, right now she's quiet.
I wasn't prepared for the... fans being... kind of knowing everywhere, knowing where I am.
Always the little dogs that make all the noise.
I wasn't prepared for, you know, perhaps outside my house.
Mm.
I happened to move house because
I don't have a gate where they can't get in.
Yeah.
So I had to.
He's only barking because someone's
door.
I wasn't
prepared for that side of things.
Yeah.
But I'm not complaining though, at all. I just didn't know how to deal with it.
Even if they're not before you bark.
I'm all smiley saying hi to everyone, and my security guard's like, "You need to move," and I'm like, "But wait. Hello, hi, and they're like all trying to like grab my hair. I had a bad incident in Glasgow once. Not that I don't love Glasgow, I do love Glasgow, but we were in a club, and I think it was a male who was trying to get my attention, and my security guard was trying to take me out of the club, and this club was packed.
Yeah.
I'm talking loads of people in there, you know, just trying to grab anything. And I'm walking through the crowd, and somebody grabs my head. And my hair.
Your actual head.
Yeah, my head. But they grabbed it so hard that I got a big bump on my head. And my stylist, Christina, also had a big bump on her forehead.
Yeah.
And it was, like, really dangerous.
Well, now you want back in, dog?
And then my security guard kind of, like, pushed him away. And it was pretty scary.
And was there a point where you felt like, okay, it's actually happening now? For some people, it's like when they start getting recognized. Some people, it's when they meet their idol. Some people, it's when a record is in the chart. What was the point where you were like, yes, I do not have to do anything else now? So
I think at Shepherd's Bush Empire, selling it out.
Your name.
And I saw my name. What's you don't understand. Like, when it hits you, you just, it comes out of nowhere. Because you're always so busy.
Yeah.
And I'm always kind of going somewhere, meeting new people, kind of doing interviews, doing this, doing that. I never got a chance to sit down and just like absorb anything. But selling out my hometown gig in my area, what else is better than that?
It's mad.
Right.
It's mad.
Apart from O2, just saying.
So well, we're in the lift, you are in costume, and this is an awesome costume.
Thank you.
Space woman, wow.
Yes, this is like a radioactive theme. I'm so nervous right now, I can't even remember what I'm going to say to you right now.
So I've got to tell everyone where we are. We're in the lift, we are about to start your show. Headline.
Yes.
I can actually see you buzzing.
Can you see?
I can feel it.
Like I don't even know what's going to happen. I'm just like really buzzing.
So there's like hundreds of people out there who have paid good money to come and see you live.
Yeah.
Just around the corner from the area you grew up.
Yeah.
How are you feeling?
Stuff we dug out.
I have to give them what they paid for.
Yeah.
It's showtime.
That's the new thing, right? They will have to eat out.
Have fun, enjoy it.
They don't want
to. I'm gonna go find a comfortable seat. I'm screaming loud.
Now I took good stuff out. Took the exploding stuff out.
Yeah.
In the day. For avoiding most of it. Sending most of it to the void. Edge of the world. Good work. I need overclockers. Just keeping an eye on it. Fine.
Alright, so this really is triple A access. Side of stage, Shepherd's Bush.
I gotta have some more overclockers.
I can hear some rock music playing.
What do I change?
Welcome boss, you can call him. Jay-Z's music playing. Iggy Azalea was the warm-up act. The crowd are very much excited and hyped about what's about to go down. She's putting on the last bit of her costume. It's a whole lot of dress. Woo! This is pretty exciting. Yeah, man. About to hit the stage, literally.
It should be one.
No turning back. So, Rita, Aura, Access, all areas. It's been an exciting day. This is what it all kind of leads up to. No spillage. No spillage. this is what the whole day leads up to. It's quite exciting, isn't it? It's quite buzzy. It's quite crazy. Mad atmosphere side of stage. Loads of cameras flashing. The stylists who are all occupying the room.
Tell me what I know
for you. A lot of hairsprays flying all over the place. The makeup is looking crisp. And it's about to go down.
That's lunch, please.
This is important.
What is the fucking command for that? Give me a headache.
That egg sounds good.
It's
Dang it, I only need one more string.
You want to say?
You need an honor. You want?
Dang it, I only need one string. Talk to myself.
Not a lot has changed since I've known you as a teenager, and a lot has stayed the same. What are you gonna keep the same?
But I'm breaking out of bone.
What are the things that you'd like to change?
Baby, it's you!
I'm joking.
What would I like to change? I would love to not change anything.
Okay.
I don't want to change anything. My team is incredible, my band is incredible, my family is incredible. Nothing.
Just this dude
that's fucking out.
And get it out there.
That's it, really.
Like, you better rub.
Ah, there
you go. Do you want her rubbing your way?
You want her rubbing your way?
You got it, you got it.
You
got it, you
got it.
It's a gun for me, man. Got it. Actually, you got things on it.
I might want to go to a different
room. Maybe. Ah, you stay here. Fucker. What the hell?
Dan, just tell me if you need call, babe. Alright.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's it.
Cool. So all my pictures from the day behind the scenes on Rita Ora's UK tour, head to bbc.co.uk/oneextra.
Didn't that hurt you? Hurt you in that day?
Oh, it was amazing. I can't actually breathe. We had a few technical difficulties, but it's fine. Doesn't matter. It's fine. The screen wouldn't work, but it's okay. We made rock anyway. We did a whole a cappella section, so it was fine.
Oh,
amazing. London, I knew it. Best crowd ever. I knew it. It's because I'm home. I love you. Thank you.
So, a day in the life of Rita Ora.
Rita
Ora, access all areas. I am absolutely knackered. So,
I'm tired. I gotta get ready to go, guys.
From her being home city of
there's
London.
A pack almost
and, I'm knackered. A day in the life of Rita Ora, access all areas, was a very tiring one. The girl works hard, she's into what she does, and she stayed the same. Known her for a very long time, and she stayed real, that's what I've said. I'm knackered, I'm back on the radio tomorrow morning. See ya, bye.
Okay, I'm heading to spawn for like an hour. Yeah, the zombie grinder.
You're locked into the fresh sounds of BBC Radio 1 Extra.
First for hot new music.
First for hot new music.
Extra R&B.
Extra hip hop.
And everything in between.
Sunday night.
On BBC Radio 1 Extra.
Coming up later this evening. Coming up. From 2 a.m.
Bye.
Destination Africa. This is the sound of Africa. Destination Africa.
Yeah, tickle was a ball, Mike.
She did work for a day. We're making world class music with an African
accent. Destination Africa. BBC Radio 1 Extra.
Oh, yeah. Are you ready? Start on a beat. I get you plenty money. I will buy you all you want.
The song trap room, John. Top of the water, no, we don't.
Holy crap.
Oh, crap, did I just fall to the screen?
What? I'm about to have the best sword in the game.
Is that what you've been doing, Sean?
Now I'm looking through all my books and
Ruby
thinking about what I can do with them. But it's about to... It's gonna be what I'm gonna be doing for a while.
There's water everywhere.
Sounds of the motherland, it's your boy DJ once again. Afros Airlines coming your way for the next couple of hours. Special moment today at 7 p.m. on One Extra, brand new show with the legendary Mr. David Rodden in the building. So you can catch Rodden every Sunday night from 7 p.m. till 9 p.m. right here on One Extra. Playing you some exciting roots and dub for 2 hours. Absolutely quality music from the Don of Reggae Dancehall himself. Rodigan is in the building each and every Sunday. Remember, you can jump online and check out that show again, bbc.co.uk/oneextra. And on behold for us, we had Rita Ora, AAA, Access All Areas Special Story as a part of BBC Radio 1 and 1 Extra's Access All Areas Month. And my boy Twin B got a unique access to Rita Ora. Lucky, lucky boy. Spent the day with the pop star as she prepared for the opening night of her gigs at Shepherd's Bush Empire in London. If you missed it, once again, jump online, bbc.co.uk/oneextraaccessallareas. My favorite part is the panoramic view of the whole building. I love that. Jump on and check it out. So right about now, some of the big tunes from the motherland. Started off with Wizkid, featured by Saz on that beat from Nigeria. Right about now, let's go on to South Africa. This one is so massive in South Africa. It was in our top five last week. That means the top five has changed. Special guests passing through. DNA Mix, where we fuse hip-hop, R&B, dancehall over Afrobeats. And my man Scob taking over the final hour of the show. But before all that, big tunes coming your way. Let's go. My figgy's all right now. This is Corner, the Uhuru Mix. Big, big, massive tune, South Africa.
sides for free as well.
Hmm?
Oh, sorry, I'm talking to myself, dude. Just,
I think you were starting to work. It's awesome.
Yeah. You're not on there now, are you?
What?
On my screen.
No. Yeah, I can hit one hit mobs now. How the hell are they getting out? Okay, mobs are getting out of the brander. Turn this off and fix it. So I see the problem, there's a hole in it.
Man, it's filled with that house all the time.
Oh, I fixed it. Hey Dan, what was the name of your old pig?
My old pig?
Yeah. Before you died in the void.
I can't remember the name of it. Yeah, I can't remember the name of it, dude, so.
Okay.
Yeah, that was easy to die as well.
That'd be crazy, all that thing he did on that sorting thing going down to the bedrock. He's about to get eaten out. About to get taken off.
Alright guys, that is it for tonight on the stream. Thanks for stopping by. Like I said, I have got 11 days off coming up as of this Thursday coming. So expect to see a lot more streaming from moi. Until next time people, peace out.
Come on, dog, you're on my court, you know that, right? You're laying on my court. What? You want under the blanket?
Dan, you've got to see the sword.
Nah.
It's got sharpness 4 on it, destruction 4 on it, fire aspect 2, vorpal 2, and unbreaking 3.
Nah.
And I named it. Then I had to take. As efficiency 4 on breaking 3 and 14-3.